Yo, what's up guys, Marv from Wandering Souls, back with a new video. This time, a list you probably were waiting for, the album of the year list, or in my words, my favorite albums of 2019. Let's put down music a bit. We're listening to Motley Crue, Shout at the Devil. Really cool band. Some people wouldn't expect from me, but I also play this music sometimes, so let's see how it goes. Anyways, the year list. I decided to do more albums than I did previous years. Why? Well, I want to give you guys more albums to check out. Of course, this is not my whole list. I'll put it down there in the description and the rest of the list, maybe not. Otherwise, it will be linked to my webpage where the whole list is published. 60 records. I'm gonna show you only 20 on this video, otherwise the video will be fucking huge. So I try to keep it short and not go into detail which pressing and whatever it is, just gonna show you the records. Tell you a little bit about it and go over to the next one. I hope that's okay with you guys. If not, sorry, that's how it goes here. First one up, the number 20, Abyssal with a Beacon in the Husk, an album I've got pretty late in this year, but I really enjoyed it. Fantastic Black Death from the UK. Really gnarly atmosphere, death metal, dark sounding. I really enjoyed it. I don't know if I enjoyed it much as the previous work. I think I enjoyed those albums a bit more, but this album is definitely really not bad. It's really, really good and definitely needs a spot in my year list. So here it is, Abyssal with a Beacon in the Husk. Next up, I'll go over to some vinyl here, an album that I really enjoyed. It is some Death Doom. This is Swallow the Sun with When a Shadow is Forced into the Light, and sorry for the light glare here. Fantastic album, double LP, fantastic Death Doom. Melancholic where it needs to be, a bit more aggressive where it needs to be, definitely really nice balance, a really nice follow-up to the previous record. I really enjoyed it, so that's why it's on the number 19. Swallow the Sun with a Shadow is Forced into the Light. Next up is the number 18, and that's also a late incoming, the Scheduled Decapitation with Death Atlas. Yes, it's not really high as much as some people would have expected here. Of course, it didn't get enough listenings because it was late in this year, but also I kept switching around with stuff, and eventually this album dropped a few places, so sorry for that, but this is definitely a pretty good album. Some people complain about more clean vocals on this album. I don't give a fuck actually. It sounds pretty good to me, and I really enjoyed the album, the songs. Really go like switching styles in music and vocals, and definitely really, really great album. Okay. Number 17, another death metal album. This is Tomb Mold with Planetary Clairvoyance. Fantastic, fantastic death metal. Sounds a bit mixture Finnish death metal, like Demolik and stuff like that, with some incantation stuff, but then more progressive in a way. Space themed lyrics, so I really enjoy that. Not a lot of death metal bands do that, only a few actually. This band. A few others can come on the right. Of course, Blood Incantation is one of them. Warmed is also a band with space themed lyrics, and Tomb Mold is one of them as well. But fantastic stuff. definitely a really great album to pick up. If you need an album from 2019, a really good death metal album, take a look into this one. Great stuff. Two Molds with Planetary Glare Avoidance. Next up, Italian death metal. This is some brutal death metal, a bit technical in a way. This Hour of Penance with Misotheism. Fantastic record. I really enjoyed this one. I definitely needed more spins to get a bit higher, but yeah, guys, time is running short. I wanted to make this list and don't want to wait too long to get some stuff higher in the list. I just give a lot of spins, of course, but not enough, I think. Because I really love this band, I have all the albums and I'm definitely stoked to own this one. So yeah, Hour of Penance, Misotheism, great band. Something completely different, an album that has a lot of spins this year. This album came pretty early, Flotsam and Jetsam with The End of Chaos. Fantastic thrash metal. Yeah, I really enjoyed this fucker. I spin it a lot in the beginning of the year, and later on I revisited and I really still really enjoyed this record, so that's why it's in my top 20. Fantastic riffing, great vocals, fantastic songs. Flotsam and Jetsam, The End of Chaos, fantastic thrash. If you don't know, own this one and you love thrash metal, go look it up. Fantastic album. Go over to some tapes here. First one is some raw black metal from Portugal. This is Black Celeste with Transfixion of Spirits. Really raw black metal. There's some great riffing. Yeah, fantastic project. The band is that raw that the riffs are not always make out clearly, but this album has production that is better than the early material, so the riffs come out more better than the early stuff. I have been lucky to see this band live and they kill it live as well. So if you're not familiar with Black Celeste and you're a black metal lover, guys, you're missing out. Really fantastic raw black metal. Transfixion of Spirit by Black Celeste. Then over to some other black metal from the US. This is Meinenwerfer with Alpenpässe. Doesn't sound really American, but that's because they sing about First World War themed stuff. This is of course something which was going on in the Alps. Fantastic riffing, great songs. I picked up this pretty late because it was released pretty late, but I definitely really enjoyed it. Definitely would climb up more if I had more time, if the year was a few months longer, but this is fantastic stuff. Meinenwerfer, Alpenpässe. Go check it out. Something completely different, over to vinyl again. This album is an album I spin when I have a lot of chill modes. I have had a few this year, and this album really came in handy. It's not metal at all, but I really, really, really enjoyed it. Great singer, fantastic music, really dark folk music. Singer-songwriter stuff. This is Chelsea Wolfe with her latest album, Birth of Violence. Yeah, fantastic female artist. Really stoked to have something in the collection from her. I have some other stuff as well, but really stoked to have this album. Great release, and definitely will give it some more spins in the future, because I really like to come back to this album when I need some chill mode time. So, fantastic stuff. Birth of Violence by Chelsea Wolfe. over to some black metal again. This is some black metal from Finland. It is symphonic black metal. This is Vargraf with Reign in Supreme Darkness. Second full length from this one man project. Really great band. More developed than the first album. And I'm really looking forward what he's gonna do next with the next album. Love the artwork as well. Really sounds a bit like 90s symphonic black metal, only with a more raw finishing touch, finish, sounding accent. Fantastic stuff, Vargraf with Reign in Supreme Darkness. Raw German black metal, more a classical raw black metal sounds like they did in Norway and stuff, only fast paced. This is Darker Nocturne Slaughter Cult with Mardom. Female fronted black metal band, a fantastic band, fantastic musicians, and I really like the high screechy vocals from the female singer. Fantastic stuff. Really glad he came back after such a long period, and they definitely made it come clear that they are not there are a band to be reckoned with. Great bands, Dark Nocturne, Slaughter Cult, Mardom, definitely a really cool black metal album. It's time to have a drink here because my throat is gonna dry out a bit here. Beavertown Neck Oil Session IPA. Never had this one, but this one was in a beer advent calendar I got from my girlfriend. Yeah, let's try this one. Really like the red topping as well on the can. It's pretty cool. Yeah, it definitely tastes like an IPA. Yeah, pretty good stuff. If you're not familiar with it, and you like dry hoppy IPA stuff. Over to some other darkness. This is Dark Throne with Old Star. An album I really come to like. Yeah, what can I say, guys? This album has shown a lot in the VC, in the black metal community, or on YouTube. So I don't have to explain too much. You know what this is. You know how it sounds. Either you like this sound of this band or you don't. I like it. I like almost all facets of this band. Dark Throne with Old Star, great album. Fantastic two piece from Norway, long existence, so everybody knows this great band. Over to some death metal again. An album I really came to love last couple of months. Nile with Vile Nolotic Rites, fantastic comeback album. Newer lineup, and they did really good. After Dallas Taylor Wade quit the band, I felt there was coming a gap, but the new guy is filling a gap up pretty good, I have to say. The sound is more clear, you can instruments hear better. Songs are great structured. This is definitely a really, really great album. It's one of the better albums in years, and I really enjoyed this. So if you are not familiar with the latest Nile, go look this up. Vile Neurotic Rites by Nile. New York black metal. I'm going pretty fast through this deck. Yeah, you probably guys know this, but that's how it goes. An album that was album of the year a couple of years ago in my list. This time they scored a big high place again. Not the first place, but number 7 is not bad, I think. Yellow Eyes with Rare Field Ceiling. Fantastic, fantastic raw black metal, cold riffing, really cool vocals. Yeah, really, really great stuff. Gilead Media has released this. Fantastic, fantastic stuff. Definitely in the vein of the previous album, but the band got a bit bad luck because there were another few other good albums that were also released this year, so it was not number one this year, but fantastic stuff, guys. Yeah, if you're not familiar with Yellow Eyes and you like black metal, give it a shot and you might enjoy it. Rare Field Ceiling by Yellow Eyes, great black metal from New York. And an album I have on CD and vinyl, but I show here the vinyl version. This is Infected Rain with Endorphine. Yeah, I'm really into this band. Last couple of years, I really enjoyed the music. Fantastic metalcore, harsh vocals, clean vocals, fantastic songs. I really enjoyed this. It had to be in my year list. It's a band I really enjoy, have seen live. I'm a member of a fan group of this band. Great stuff. Endorphine, the newest album. I think it's the fourth album. Fantastic stuff from Moldova. If you're not familiar with it, go look it up. If you like things like Ginger or that kind of bands, definitely will have a look into this. Great stuff. Then an album I haven't shown yet on my channel, but I have it. I got it in pretty late, so that's why I haven't shown it yet. Probably be will in CD update, maybe not, I don't know. We'll see. I show it anyways now. A lot of people are talking about this album, and I have to say, I heard it and it is fantastic. I bought it and listened to it a couple of times and I thought, man, this has to be high in my year list. This is fantastic, fantastic death metal. It really stood up. I think this album is better than the previous album, Starspawn. Although I thought this was a really great album, but this album tops it. Hidden History of the Human Race by Blood Incantation. Fantastic space themes, death metal. If you like stuff like Incantation and Lake, or Morbid Angel, later work of Death, definitely has progressive elements in this. Guys, you will enjoy this. Great riffing. I've only four songs, but the last song is fucking long. I think 18 minutes or so. Divided in four parts, and it has a very nice flow going all over it into the other parts. All the songs sound fantastic as well, like the Geezer Power Plant. It's a fantastic, fantastic song. Really, really great stuff. Blood Incantation with Hidden History of the Human Race. Definitely an album of the year, must have for your list. If you don't have it, go fucking buy it. Fantastic album. Next one, an album I finally had in not so long ago, but I heard a song a couple of months ago called Serpentine. And that was a song that really thought I have to grab this album. The second single of this album, Will You Kiss Me If You Will You Still Kiss Me If You See You In Heaven? If I Will you still kiss me if I see you in heaven? Sorry, Anyways, it's Undress the Madness by Pretty Maids. Yes, something completely different, but I really, really, really love this fucking album. I swear here, but it's great. Great songs, great riffing, great vocalist. Ronnie Atkins already outdone himself here. It's definitely one of the better albums in the discography, and I'm really glad that I own this album. I almost didn't get it, but I was fed up with it. Delivery took some time and time and time again. I ordered somewhere else, and finally it came in. I was really stoked to have this. When I got it in, I spun it a few times after each other, and I really loved it. I climbed very high in my year list. It's a really slow grower, getting more and more of you. You like it at the first straight away, but it grows more and more you listen to it. Great, great band. Pretty Maids from Denmark. If Undress Your Madness. Then an album a lot of people seems to enjoy, and I can't blame them. Really nice comeback, definitely back to their older sound. Since Mysterious Dumps and Talents, I think this is their best album, in my opinion. This is Damon from Mayhem. Fantastic, fantastic black metal from this band. They're really back in form, and a lot of people were waiting on an album like this from the band. They have done a lot of experiments in their sound throughout the years, and always took a lot of time to release an album, but finally an album that comes near in the Mysterious Dumb Satanas. I really love it. Great riffing. Attila is also a really great form on this album. Fucking love it. Great black metal, yearless material for everyone who's in black metal, I think. Great, great band. The last tape in this deck, another black metal album. An album I got to know through another YouTube channel, and looked it up at the Bandcamp and whatever. I really, really enjoyed this. Great band, fantastic riffing, great, great sound. Never heard about this band, and it's not really strange. This is their first album. I'm talking about Totenbacher with their Schwarze Hort. Fantastic, fantastic black metal. I think they're from Germany, if I'm not mistaken. Really, really great band. Love everything about the sound. Really enjoy the artwork as well. See, artwork and vinyl artwork, I think, is in black and white, but this one is colored, the tape version. But don't bother me, it looks great, sounds great, and I'm really glad to own this. On number 2, Totenwache, weer de Schwarze Hort. And then the number 1, an album probably some people would have respect if you see my reaction videos to this band. Really blew my mind, made me fucking crazy. Devourment, with Obscene Majesty, that's my number 1 for this year. Fantastic, brutal, death metal, slam here and there. Fantastic sound, going back to the old sound of Molesting the Decapitated. Raw, death metal, deep vocals. Change in singer did really something to the sound of this band, and I'm really glad that they made an album like this again. Not that I really liked the previous albums, but this album sounds more raw, into your face, brutal. I really enjoy it. Devourment, Obscene Majesty, great release. And definitely will give this more spins in 2020. You can ensure that. Fantastic stuff. Great band. Number 1. That's it, guys. My year list. I try to take all albums that I own So if you want to see the rest of my list, it will be in the description or on my website. You'll see how it goes, because the list is pretty long and it takes a lot of space. But I will put the names down there so you can look all the things up. That's it. So if you haven't seen a certain album, it could be that I don't own it, haven't heard it enough, or I don't like it. There's no other way. I have 60 albums in this list. It was not as big as last year, but if I add all the stuff that I don't add, all the stuff, if I add all the stuff that I don't own, then I will probably come near 100. But I try to get most of the albums that I have in my list and really enjoy it. And some stuff I haven't heard enough or have owned yet, and then I think I can add it to the list, because I have to hear the albums before I can judge, I think. So anyways, I hope you enjoyed the list, this video. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Have you heard some albums of this, or have you questioned or something about something? Just go ahead. Hope to see you guys back soon in next year. Maybe I'm gonna squeeze in one video, and if not, then I wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. And hope to see you guys back in 2020. Thank you for tuning in, for supporting me, and for the likes and the subscriptions. I really appreciate it. The channel has grown a lot since the last couple of months, and I really enjoyed that. See you guys get to know more bands through me, and I really appreciate it, because I do it for the bands, for myself, but also for you guys to get to know new stuff. So that's it. Hope to see you back soon, and take care and have a nice holiday.